In this tutorial, I will show you how to use STATA to produce graphs, especially the cross-sectional bar graphs. If you want to use the same database that I would be using for this tutorial, you can obtain that from this particular website, faculty.arts.ubc.ca. If you click on any one of these databases, you should be able to open it in STATA. Here are the variables. This is demographic health survey database. This is incomplete data for India. Incomplete because it only has information on a few of the characteristics and only for two states. First, let me talk about the data here. Each row in this case represents one woman who was the respondent in the surveys. So this one row represents this woman with case identification number as given here. Different columns represents different variables or different characteristics for this woman. Now this woman belongs to the age group 25 to 29. She lives in Gujarat in a rural area, countryside. She has secondary education and so on. So each row here is representing one woman. Let's look at some of the health statistics that we have for a woman here. We have information about the respondent's weight, height, and body mass index. So let's use the body mass index for respondent. Generate a variable called BMI, which is equal to V445. We can label this variable. Label variable BMI body mass index. Okay, so if we go down, we have created this variable BMI, body mass index, for the respondent. Now we want to see how this variable or how the health status of women differ across different states that we have information on here. Okay, tablet B024, this is for the different states. So we have information on Gujarat and Kerala. We can use a bar graph or a bar chart to see how BMI varies across different states, V024. So these are the categories. So it will divide up the mean of, it'll calculate the mean of BMI across these two categories, represented by or measured in this variable, V024. We can give it a title. We can give the title a graph. We can give the graph a title. Health status, submit. And this is what we have. The mean BMI is higher in Kerala than it is in Gujarat. Okay. There are various things we can do in a bar chart. We have categories, V024. We can have it, we can divide this category into subcategories by putting another variable in group 2. We can decide that we want it for certain characteristics and so on. Let me explain that further. Let's look at the wealth variable. We have tab V190 is your wealth index. It's a categorical variable, and we can generate wealth is equal to V190. Tabulate wealth. What you see here is that poorest was represented by number 1, 2 was defined as poorer, so this was the wealth index. What's happened here is that we've lost the label values that were attached in case of B190. Easy to show that, B190 and wealth. Let's look at these two variables side by side. So richer was actually number 4, and it is number 4 in wealth, but we've lost that label attached to number 4. We can have wealth variable, we can attach the same value labels to wealth as B190 has by the following command. Label values to wealth variable same as B190. Now if we edit the two, we realize that we have the same label variables. Okay? Now, let's look at the bar chart again. We want the categories to be wealth. We want to see how the BMI varies across wealth. It shouldn't be surprising. We should find richer women having a higher BMI. Submit. And this is what we have. Poorest, poorer, middle, richer, richest. BMI status goes up with wealth status. Suppose you wanted to categorize this further by states. So we want to see if it has the same pattern across the two states. Okay. Submit. And what we observe is that the pattern more or less looks the same. Okay, across the two states. What if we just wanted to look at pattern of wealth only for one state? Okay, only for one state. Now, B024, Gujarat is represented by number 24. Suppose you only wanted to see the bar graph for Gujarat. If V024 is equal to 24, now it would calculate the mean of BMI only for the state Gujarat. Okay? So that's how we can use the if command. The other interesting question can be, how does it vary across different religions? And the religion is variable V130. We can generate variable called religion is equal to V130. We want it to have the same values. Religion should have the same value as V130. Let's go back to this graph. We're looking at mean for BMI. We want the categories to be, the different grouping variable to be religion. Okay. Let's remove the if command. We want it for all the data points that we have. Submit. And this is what we see across religion. So the BMI health status is the best for women belonging to this religion group. Suppose we wanted to see how it varies across religion by state. What we see is that there are certain religions that are absent in Kerala, and there doesn't seem to be much variations across religion in Kerala. It does seem to exist in Gujarat, especially these first three. As you can see, we can't really distinguish between the various religions on the x-axis. One way to fix that would be to go into properties and choose how you want the labels to be attached. 45 degrees, 90 degrees, I find that 45 degrees seem to have a nice, seem to be nicely represented. Okay, so that's what, this is what we see. Hindu, Muslim, Christians, we don't see that difference in Kerala. Let's look at son preferences. Okay, ideal number of boys, ideal number of girls. Let's generate a variable called son preference is equal to people who prefer boys over 6 to 8 who prefer girls. So this is our son preference. We can label this variable preference for sons. Okay. Here is our variable preference for sons. Okay. Now let's create a bar chart. Instead of BMI, we want to look at son preferences. Okay. In this case, it's not really a binary variable. We haven't changed it yet. Let's look at son preferences across religion. And this is what we see. Higher in Sikhs and Hindus and Muslims than in Christians, among Christians. Okay? We might also want to see this across education groups. Look for education. B149 for the mother. Let's go back to this graph bar and say we want it for B149. And what we find is, again, we'll need to change this properties and have an angle of 45 degrees. Okay. So this is what we have. No education, incomplete primary, high mean of son preferences. So as education increases, son preference for sons goes down. Okay. Now we might want this across different religions, or we might just want this for a specific religion. Okay. Let's do this for different religions. It's going to be a very tough looking graph, but what we can do is we can do this for some religions. We know that there are three religions that are have a higher frequency, and we can ignore the ones that do not have a high frequency. Okay, code book, religion 1, 2, 3. So we want religion to be above, to be less than 4 to capture all these three different religions categories. Okay. So if religion is less than 4, so here we'll have Hindu, Muslims, and Christians. Submit, and this is what we have. We're looking at son preference, and we find that there isn't much son preference among Christians. Among Hindus, as education increases, we do see a decline in son preferences, and somewhat similar thing happens in Muslims, though there is this outlier here where we have incomplete primary. So this is how you can have categories and subcategories and use the if commands. The other thing that you can do is, we're looking at B149, which is education. Suppose we create a variable that we do not have label for. And in that case, we can override the labels and create our own labels. Now, bi graph does the same thing that the subgrouping does. The only difference is you'll have graphs separately for the two categories. In this case, I have used the command by. So what you see is we have son preferences, and we are calculating the mean across education groups for the different states. And what we see here is that education does not seem to play much of a role in Kerala, but it does seem to play a role in Gujarat. And that is